I'm Bob Niversky, National Program Leader for Bio-Based Pest Management with the National Institute of Food and Agriculture, and this is the USDA's SBIR program. So we have an annual budget of $22 million and funding opportunities for Phase 1 and Phase 2 grants. The Phase 1 grant is up to 8 months for $100,000. If you need more time, you can always ask for a no-cost extension. The Phase 2 grants are for up to 2 years, and again, you can ask for a no-cost extension if you need more time, and at a funding level of up to $600,000. The funding rates are more difficult in the Phase 1 grants, with funding at around 15% or so, and this goes up to better odds in the Phase 2 program, funding nearly 50% of the Phase 2 grants. We have commercialization assistance programs for both Phase 1 and Phase 2 winners. And in 2016, we had 76 Phase 1 proposals and 34 Phase 2. And 2017, 88 Phase 1 and 26 Phase 2 proposals that were funded. We have a whole bunch of different topics that are funded in the USDA program dealing with air, water, and soil. Animal production and protection, aquaculture, biofuels and bio-based products, food science and nutrition, forests and related resources, and then small and mid-sized farms, rural and community development, and these off-shelf technologies are allowed in these two topic areas. And then we have plant production and protection engineering that deals with things like drones that are evaluating crops for drought stress or insect or disease damage. And then on the plant side biology, we have plant production and protection biology that deals with more plant-related topics. For our Phase 1, the RFA hopefully is going to come out within the next couple of weeks, and typically is late because of Congress. The proposal deadline will probably be sometime in October 2017. Our panels deliberate in January and February 2018, and notification sometime in March. And then the awards come out June through August 2018. For Phase 2 proposals, these are only open to Phase 1 awardees, so you have to garner a Phase 1 before you can move on to Phase 2. But the Phase 1s, you can come back again and reapply without problem. So take those comments to heart and then come back with a stronger proposal. Don't get discouraged if your proposal is rejected for the first time. You've had two or folks come back two or three times before they were successful. Now when you apply for a Phase 2, you only get one shot. So make sure you're ready to come forward with a Phase 2 before you apply for it. So the Phase 2, we have the RFAs that are released sometime in December. Proposal deadline, March sometime. Panels deliberate in May. And notification in June 2018 with awards coming forth in September 2018. And then they wanted us to highlight it as per agencies, some of the innovative research and commercialization projects. Here's one called Stony Creek Colors. And this made the 2016 American Made Honoree United States of Innovation in 2017. So you can see all the different products here from indigo plants to farmers and farms to Stony Creek Colors to mills to brands and really innovative new dye approaches. And Alteros Energy, this is really a neat one. This created a turbine that acts just like a kite that goes up into the air and catches stronger wind currents and then generates energy from that. So this was from Alteros Buoyant Airborne Turbine Technology. So this was a commercial product sold in 2015. The technology was featured in CNN's 2014 edition of the CNN 10 Inventions and in the New York Times. And the telecoms group SoftBank has invested $7 million in Alteros Energy for the future deployment of the buoyant airborne turbine. And if you have any questions, our overall coordinator for the SBIR program with the USDA is Scott Dawkins. And here's his contact information. Notice I didn't put mine in. Okay, thank you.